In animals, meiosis only happens in special diploid cells called germ cells. A diploid cell, which is designated as 2N, has two copies of each chromosome. One copy is inherited from each biological parent. We call these two copies a pair of homologous chromosomes, or homologs. Preceding meiosis, a germ cell goes through interphase, during which the cell grows, its DNA is replicated, and its organelles are duplicated. During interphase, the chromosomes are usually decondensed or unwound. Here, however, the chromosomes are shown as being condensed or tightly wound. This helps to illustrate that the process of DNA replication results in each chromosome being copied. The identical copies of a chromosome that result from DNA replication are called sister chromatids. The centrosome is also copied so that the cell is ready to enter meiosis at the end of interphase. Meiosis consists of two divisions, meiosis I and meiosis II. Each of these divisions has four different phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Each meiotic division is followed by a process known as cytokinesis. Let's learn more about meiosis and cytokinesis. Meiosis I begins with prophase I. During prophase I, the chromosomes condense. The homologs then pair up tightly, or synapse. Following synapsis, crossing over occurs, during which non-sister chromatids of a pair of homologs exchange corresponding sections of DNA. This exchange of DNA is important as it helps to introduce genetic variation. Toward the end of prophase I, the nuclear envelope breaks down and the meiotic spindle forms. Microtubules from opposite spindle poles extend outward and attach to the kinetochore on each homolog. The microtubules move the pairs of homologs back and forth toward the metaphase plate. Metaphase I occurs once the pairs of homologs are randomly and independently aligned along the metaphase plate. This also helps to introduce genetic variation. During anaphase I, the microtubules separate the pairs of homologs and pull the homologs toward opposite spindle poles of the cell. Note that the sister chromatids remain attached to each other. During telophase I, the meiotic spindle breaks down. In some species, the nuclear envelope may briefly reappear to produce two separate nuclei, and the chromosomes may decondense. For simplicity, we're showing the chromosomes in their condensed state here. Cytokinesis, which is the division of the cytoplasm, occurs toward the end of meiosis I. During cytokinesis, the cell is pinched in half, which eventually produces two separate cells. The two cells that result from meiosis I are both haploid, which is designated as N, as they have one copy of each chromosome. Because of crossing over and the independent assortment of chromosomes during meiosis I, the two cells are genetically distinct from each other. Meiosis II follows after the first cytokinesis and begins with prophase II. During prophase II, the nuclear envelopes break down and the meiotic spindles form in each of the cells. Microtubules from opposite spindle poles attach to the kinetochore of each chromatid. The microtubules move the chromosomes back and forth toward the metaphase plate. Metaphase II occurs once each of the chromosomes is aligned on the metaphase plate. During anaphase II, the sister chromatids of each chromosome separate, and the microtubules pull them toward opposite spindle poles of the cell. Once separated, the chromatids are now referred to as chromosomes. During telophase II, the chromosomes arrive at the spindle poles, and the meiotic spindles break down. The nuclear envelopes reform, which results in two nuclei in each cell. Lastly, the chromosomes decondense. During cytokinesis, the cytoplasm of each cell divides into two separate cells. The end result of meiosis is that four cells have been produced. Each of these cells is haploid, and each cell is genetically distinct, with its own unique combination of genes.